Hi guys, his name is Johnson. I'm coming with a new video blog format today. I'm testing out this use of PowerPoint slides and screen recording software to see if I can deliver when I want to do a lecture type teaching, see if I can use this format as a lecture type teaching format. So let me know your thoughts in the comments on this new format. So for today, I want to talk about why, what, and how. These are three most important words you need to know for your business. These are the three most important words you need to find for your business, and these are the three most important words you need to communicate to your customers. But before I get into what these three most important words are and what they mean, I want to give a quick plug for my new book, Take Control of Your Financial Destiny. I've gotten some great feedback from people who started reading the book and going through it. I heard one lady already told me that she's put sticky notes all over the book. And I'm getting a lot of great feedback from this, and people tell me that this is really helpful for them in launching their business. And just even they are in business, I also get feedback telling me that this is good stuff for them in terms of just knowing how to do business better. So let me tell you what's in the book. The book was designed to be a merger of spiritual concepts plus practical know-how. Because I've read a lot of business books, and I've not really seen any books that really merge those two things together, where you talk about hearing God and you also talk about the just 1-3 steps actually doing it. So this book is broken into 9 principles. And the first thing I discuss are spiritual fundamentals to developing God into our business. That's one of the first things, concerns with tithes and offering, and what is God's perspective about business. The next thing I just talk about is understanding money, because businesses deals with money, and you really got to understand what this concept of money is in order to have a successful business. The third principle is business basics. You got to understand the basis of business. You got to understand the basis of making the decision, running a company, setting up structures, understanding how your business fit in the marketplace. Then I go into personal development. You can see how this book is kind of all inclusive. I want this book to be this one-stop shop for everything you need to know about business. And so we talk about personal development because how you develop personally affects your business. And as Christian entrepreneurs, our businesses are affected by our personal lives. So, for example, if our marriage is not in order, our business is not going to be in order, because God looks on marriage with very important eyes, and He's not going to bless your business if it's going to kill your marriage. So, you got to have certain things in your personal life in order to be a God entrepreneur. The next I'm dealing with is business entities. So, when you start your business, you got to incorporate in some form or fashion. Are you going to be an LLC? Are you going to be a C corporation? Or were you thinking about not incorporating at all? In that chapter on business entity, I go through all the details of what that means, and I also give some suggestions about what you should choose. The next concept is protecting your ideals. Now, some of you guys are inventing things or doing things, and we got to talk about, are you going to get a patent? Are you going to get a copyright on some of your works? Are you going to trademark your stuff? So those are things we got to talk about in protecting your ideals. Next, web technology. The web is a great equalizer. In today's world of web technology, you can be a one-man show and feel like a big business. So you really got to understand what's going on in the world of web technology. Marketing strategies. Marketing is the blood of your business. And in some sense, I had an interview with one of my guests. I think her name is Shalita Williams. She said, if you only had a little bit of money, the best thing to do is go learn how to sell and market. So marketing is one of the most important things you got to do. So this book goes over marketing strategies, kind of give you the heart behind, you know, why certain things work, why certain things doesn't work. So you got to develop a great marketing strategy for your business. And finally, I get into how to launch your business. I go through a series of steps, how to think through it, how to write it down, and actually how to do it. So this is not a section on writing a business plan, because sometimes a business plan could be limiting, and also the business plan could be a waste of time, and also the business plan could also be an excuse not to start your business. So in this chapter, I go through some very basic stuff of how to launch your business. So I suggest, you know, pick up the book, you know, tell me what you think, read through it. It's really going to help you get going what God's called you to do. And it goes through everything. So I want this to be the one place, the one-stop shop for everything you need to know. All right, now we're done with our commercial. Let's get back to why, what, and how. Why? Why are you doing this? That's the first question you got to address before you go into business. Why are you doing this thing? Why did God call you to do this? Why are you going to spend all your time doing this? Why are you going to spend time away from your family to do this? Why are you going to do this in addition to working a job? Why are you going to spend time? Why are you going to charge money for this? Why do people even want this? You got to start with your why. And what I want to do for these next set of this next segment here, I want to give you my why, and I want to show you my what and my how as an example. So this is not really a promotional part. It may seem like it's promotional, but it's really I want to show you through an example how I do what I do in terms of Christian entrepreneurship. So what's my why? This is my why. Because financial prosperity comes from faith in God, plus action needs to be taken also. And for most people, that action is Christian entrepreneurship. So here's the story. I've been to church many years now, and I've been born again and saved since the late 90s. And I've grown up in a prosperity ministry, and I've seen a lot of people hear this ministry, hear this prosperity gospel, but yet they've not increased financially. Now, there's nothing wrong with the prosperity ministry because they're preaching the word, but the thing that people are lacking is they're lacking this concept of taking action. And if you don't take action, like James said, faith without works is dead. So you got to take action. For most people, that action is Christian entrepreneurship. And I'm tired of seeing people that can't pay their bills, can't do the things they want to do, can't go on a vacation they want to go on to, because when you're an employee, you're working on a very fixed income and you're working on limited revenue, limited resource. All your time is going into working for somebody else and building somebody else's business up. So your action you got to take is Christian entrepreneurship. And you see the picture I have here of a homeless guy. And one thing that really hurt my heart is I see homeless people and I know that these people have families. These people have friends. And guess what? Those family members, those friends, they can't help because they're struggling themselves financially. And so my why is that I need you to become financially prosperous so you can go help the people around you and help them become financial prosperity. And if you want to eradicate homelessness, every person that's homeless has somebody in their family that know that they're homeless that could reach out to them if they had the means to help them, to train them, and get them out of that situation. So for my why, it's personal because I hate to see people financially strapped. I want to see people financially blessed, financially prosperous. And I know that what's lacking is, yes, we have faith for it, but until we take action, it's not going to happen. So that's my why. And so for you, you got to have a why like that. You got to have a why that's passion. You got to have a why that gets you up every day and drives you to do what you do. That why is going to keep you going through the storms of developing your business. Next, what are you doing? Now, I talked about why you're doing. Now we got to talk about what are you doing. For me, what am I doing? I'm teaching Christians how to start and grow their own business from a biblical and practical viewpoint. Plus, I'm inspiring them to take action on what God has called them to do in business. Now, you see how the why was abstract. Now, the what is getting more concrete. I'm using words like I'm teaching you, I'm inspiring you. And so I'm going from more this abstract concept of why to a more specific concept of what. Now, my what is still not that very specific. I'm talking about teaching. I'm talking about inspiring. And you'd be like, and the next question is, how? So I'm glad you asked that. How are you doing it? So I know why I'm doing, I know what I'm doing, but how are you doing it? Here's how. Here's how I do it. I create free online content. I'm conducting live workshops. I'm doing group and individual consultation. I'm creating affordable products. So that's my how. That's how I take that abstract concept of what, that's how I take the abstract concept of why, move it to a more specific concept of what, and more to a very specific detailed discussion of how I'm doing all this stuff. So how am I helping people take control of their financial destiny? I'm doing it through these things. Online content, workshops, individual consultation, affordable products. And for you and your business, you got to come up with that how once you go through that process. Now, when you have your why, your what, and your how, the next thing you got to do is you need a bag of words to describe everything. And we have simple words. These words are going to be keywords in your mind that's going to guide you as you create stuff, as you do stuff, as you market your business. So for me, my why is my keywords, freedom, control, helping. What's freedom? Freedom to do what you want to do. Freedom from being at a 9-to-5 job that you want to do. Control. What's control? Control is control over your finances, control over your life. What's helping? Helping other people around you. Once you have freedom over your life, once you have control of your finance, you're free now to help other people. So those are the words I describe my why. What? So remember, the what is, what am I doing now? I teach, inspire, advise. So these are things, these are my what words, my how words. Now remember, how is very specific. Books, courses, coaching, workshops, podcasts, videos, articles. That's my how. So I got my why, my what, and my how. And for your business, what you have to do is you got to get these keywords, these bag of words that just stays ingrained in your mind to help you move your business forward. So when you create you have a new ideal, you judge and base with these words. Is it fitting it? Is it getting freedom? Is it creating control? Is it helping? Is it teaching? Is it inspiring? Is it advising? Is it a book, a course, or is it a workshop, a podcast, a video, or article? And that's what I want you to talk about. Now, one thing I want to bring in a point here. My why and my what are always constant. I'm always thinking about freedom, control, and helping. I'm always thinking about teaching, inspiring, and advising. But the how changes over time. Now, when I first started this, I only had podcast videos and articles. Actually, when I first started this, I only had podcasts. Then I added articles. Then I added videos. Then I added workshops. Then I added books. Then I added courses. Then I added coaching. So your how would evolve over time, but it's always linked back to your why and your what. Let's talk about your communication pathway to your potential customers. Now, when you're trying to inspire people to buy your products and services, you never start with the how part. You never say, hey, I have this book, or I have this course, or I have some coaching program. You're starting at the how. You're starting too far down the spectrum. You got to go all the way back to the why. First, you got to tell people why you're doing this. Then you got to tell people what you're doing. And then you got to tell them the how. And when you go through that communication process of saying the why, the what, and the how, you inspire people to want to get your products and services. When I talk to people, I say, hey, I'm doing this because I know that you want to have financial freedom. I know you want control of your life. I know you want to help other people. So I'm telling you that why. And in order to do that, what I do is I teach you, I inspire you. And I teach and I inspire you through books, through courses, through audios, through podcasts, through videos, through articles, through products. And you see how I went through that communication pathway with you. I told you why, I told you what, I told you how. And now at this point, this is where you realize, okay, well, now I can buy something from you. I can buy something from that how list now at this point, once I know the why, the what, and the how. And that's that communication pathway you got to have with your potential customers. So never start with how. Always start with why, and then move to what, and then move to how as a last thing if you want to sell something to your particular potential customers. All right, guys, I hope this video was helpful for you. And as I close out, I'm going to give a few plugs as part of my how. The first thing I want to just re-mention to you is the book, Take Control of Your Financial Destiny. You can buy it from my website. There should be a link at the bottom of the video to get it. It's in print or it's in ebook format. I currently have two digital MP3 courses that you can purchase. One is on blogging, and it's on blogging and social media, and that's designed particularly for people that's in ministry, and they want to use blogging and social media to spread their message. Now, if you have a business and your business has a message to share, that's also a good podcast to listen to. Not podcast, also a good MP3 course to listen to also. The other course I have is on marriage. It's on how to get your spouse on board with a vision. A lot of times with entrepreneurs, we have these visions from God, but our spouse is not on board with vision. So I have a digital MP3 course on how to get your spouse on board with vision. And now that course was delivered by, I believe, 5 different speakers. So there's a lot of information packed in those courses. And finally, I have a program which is called my Message Bearer Online Support Service. Now, this service is for people that has a message to deliver to the world, and they want to teach people, they want to inspire people, and they want to get that message out. So when God has a message he wants to share with the world, he has to give it to somebody to bear it to the earth. So for me, in my case, my message is Christian entrepreneurship. Your message could be fitness. Your message could be purpose, could be faith, it could be prayer. Whatever that message is and you want to bear it to the world, I want to help you do that. And specifically, I want to help you do that through using social media and using blogging. And that Message Bearer program gives you coaching, guidance, and tech support, actually sharing and spreading your message through social media and blogging. And so you can find all these things at my website, AmosJohnsonJr.com. All right, so this is our video, and I hope this new format was helpful to you. And just let me know in the comments what you think about this new format, and I'll talk to you guys later. Be blessed.